I recently designed my website and I wanted to see how users interact with my pages and when they exit my website. So I've been using a tool called Beusable Analytics. Beusable Analytics help you identify patterns and trends in how visitors engage with your website, allowing you to monitor visualized customer journeys of your entire service at a glance. In this video, I'm going to show you how I found Beusable Analytics useful and how it gave me the ability to showcase my customer journeys in an easy, digestible format. If you're new here, hi, what's up? I'm Gemma and I'm a senior product designer who share tips about UX for free. If that's something you're interested in, then why not hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. Using data to improve your customer journeys will help you build more useful and intelligent services that will help you retain your customers. And with Beusable Analytics, this has been made easier than ever. And also, it's free. All you need to do to get started is to install this little snippet of code within the head tag of your website. In my case, I'm using Webflow. So as you can see here, I have embedded the Beusable Analytics code. I have already set mine up, as you can see. So now let's take a look at some of Beusable Analytics features. Once everything has been installed, you will see a very high level daily report. This updates every few hours, is not actually live data, but on the right hand side here, you'll be able to see the weekly summary and you can use this data to see how users typically navigate your website. So let's move on and let's see how well my website is doing in more detail. And straight away, we can start looking at my website ranking. You can see here on the left, my page per sessions. And this means on average that users go through 2.3 pages on my website. The average page per session means that users are spending roughly about 1 minute 15 per page, or on average about 1 minute at a time per page. The PV summary is always going to be at 100%, and that means because I have less than 20 pages currently on my website. Until I have more pages on my website, this is always going to stay at 100%. We can also see the conversion average is about 54%. Drop-offs is pretty self-explanatory, and I'm not actually overly concerned about how high that number is because I know there's a lot of links on my website that link users off to different platforms. My refresh is relatively low, which is good because this means that users may be refreshing the pages. For example, users may be hoping they can speed up the process to get that page to load a little bit quicker. Rollback again is at 0%, so again that's really really good, and the rollback indicates that users may have used the back button in order to return to a previous page, and this could indicate that maybe there's some links broken on my website and users are unable to carry on within their journey. Below this we have the same data but on pages specifically. So we can see here that my home page is one of the highest ranking pages that I have. Again, this isn't uncommon for me because this is the page that's linked throughout all my YouTube videos, my Instagram and everything like that. So I'm not relatively surprised that this is the highest ranking page. And over on the right here, we do have the same data of the conversions, how many people drop off this page, how many people roll back on this page, how many people refresh this page, and also the average duration spent on this page. With that said, let's now take a look at journeys. The journeys are a great visual way to see how customers enter and leave your website from start to finish. Each node is a web page on your website. And we can see here that most of my users land on my homepage. No big surprise there, like I said previously, this is what's linked in all of my social media channels. Then after looking at this, we can see that the users tend to navigate off to my case studies. But a little spoiler alert here, my case studies are actually password protected, so unless you have a password in order to bypass this page, you will not be able to view or see any of my case studies. Then we can see if the user does have a password. They can move on to a case study. The dark green arrows show the main customer journey. And then the light green arrows show the alternative routes that your customers may have taken. I'm currently not surprised at what the data is displaying to me at the moment, as the pages that have been highlighted within the journey are what I expect my users to be looking at. As other pages are either password protected or they link you off to an alternative website. Also, if you click on one of the green options, the journey will change and you can see how users navigate through your website in different journeys. We can see here how users navigated from my resources page, which again isn't a surprise to me because my resources page is also linked in some of my YouTube videos. And then after leaving my resources page, they tend to go back to my homepage and then navigate off to an alternative page. You are also able to click on this little node here, which will then bring up a little mini report. It shows a screenshot of the page and you are able to either retake it or upload your own image if that's what you want to do as well, to see the differences between these pages. But then it also shows you some of the information that you would originally seen on the report page. So you can see the amount of sessions, the average durations that people are spending on this page, the average drop-off of this page. If a customer is inactive for 30 minutes, Beusable Analytics does count this as a drop-off. Page views, how many times they refresh or roll back. It's a nice little mini report that you're able to see straight from the journey itself. The journeys, however, give a very detailed visual way of seeing your customer's journey. And this is done without any hard work whatsoever. To be honest with you, it pretty much does everything for you. All I really needed to do was add in that snippet of code and all of this got generated off the back of that. And this allows you to see effective data quickly. Now let's take a quick look at the segmentation feature. And again, this is all on this page. We can see here the majority of my users come to my website via a desktop device. 73% of them. 1.5% of them view my website via a tablet and 25% view my website with a mobile device. Again, if I click on any of these, the journeys below will change depending on which device I'm viewing my website on. I do have a relatively low view on my tablet, which to be honest with you, I'm not very much overly concerned with that. But what I can do as well is change my journey view below on whether I want to see some new customers or returning customers. And all I really need to do is uncheck the checkbox and the journey below will change in order to match my requirements. This is a really great feature as it allows you to see what are returning customers coming back to have a look for and what are the new customers coming to take a look at. Turns out at this point that, again, my homepage is pretty popular, my case studies are pretty popular, and also my resources pages are pretty popular, which, to be honest with you, for returning customers, these are everything that I would expect to see. I can also see within my sessions as well when an influx of visitors come to my site. And this is useful to see when the patterns of users arrive on my site, and whether or not I've got consistent views or not. Looking at this graph, it looks like customers are about 7 sessions come to my website on the 13th of the 4th, 2022. The date is a little backwards, especially from the UK. So 13 is the day, 04 is the month, and 2022 is the year. I can also see here as well where people have come from in order to find my website. So if I click it, we can see that 40% of my users come to my website direct. That's a pretty good number. But what's not so surprising to me, that 24% of my customers have come from my YouTube, or 12% has come from my Linktree, and my Linktree can be found on my Instagram page in my bio. So again, I'm not overly concerned or surprised by those results. So this is really cool if you just wanted to see that type of data. So if we click on YouTube, for instance, I can pretty much already predict that, yep, it's going to show my resources page. Because like I said, on most of my videos on YouTube, there's a link to my resources page so people can come up. Groups is a good way to categorize each user into an individual group. Maybe you want to use this to filter certain pages out, or maybe you want to use it to highlight a certain user journey. Setting up a group is really easy to do. If you go over here to the groups, click automatic, and then press the cog, you should be able to then to move over to the group settings. You can see here we're in the groups. I do have a few set up, main site and client. Client is something I set up relatively earlier and is something I'm going to walk you through in a minute. But all you really need to do in order to add a new group is to click the little plus icon. We're going to name the group to whichever we want to call it. So for this instance, I'm going to call it a test group. Click confirm. This will allow me then to move any of my pages into a grouped folder. Now I have blurred out a lot of these links. For instance, if I wanted to filter out all of these, I could just click them. Just click this little tick box, add a new tag, call this not needed, click enter, and now this has created a tag. I'm just going to move them all in. Beusable Analytics is going to do its thing, and now all these are in this little tag, which are pages that are not needed, so now I can just view these as well. So now let's take a look at the groups that I've set up previously. Within here, I have 9 links in case studies. I also have a main site. So these are all pages that are relatively accessible for any user. And also have another one, which is Media Kit, which again is specific to clients. So I don't want people to really see them either. Now I've got my client group all set up, I'm going to navigate back to the customer journey. And then within my journey, I can click on my client tab, and then we can start seeing the pages that have been highlighted. So anything in purple is the target I've set up, which is my main site that anyone can get access to. But my case studies are now highlighted green, meaning that they need to have a password in order to view these pages. Again, none of this stuff I'm actually surprised about. I can see straight away that clients are going straight to my case studies, accessing my case studies because they have a password, and then they can view multiple case studies. Again, I'm going to blur out the links across the top, but you can see relatively quickly that there's a lot of users who are able to access these pages, and these are being highlighted within Beusable Analytics as well for me. So I can see how they're moving through the journey, what pages they're staying on, how long they're staying on these pages. The only people who would have access to these pages are either potential clients or potential employers. So if I was currently looking for a new job, I could see relatively quickly how many people are viewing and accessing these web pages. And that's groups. If you are someone who is data driven and has used tools like this in the past, such as Google Analytics, you will already know the difficulty in getting detailed data in an easy visual format. Beusable Analytics takes away the overwhelming pressure and allows you to see data quickly and effectively. So why not try Beusable Analytics for free? There's a link to their website in the description below. So if you want to check that out, then I highly, highly recommend it. Even if you're a first-time user and wanting to get deep down into the data, this is a relatively easy, quick tool in order to get started. I also have another video on my channel reviewing another Beusable tool, and this tool allows you to track your user behaviors. Again, if that's something you're interested in, I would leave a link in the description below and also attach it in one of the cards above. And that's it. If you have any questions, then please feel free to leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to my channel and maybe hit that like button below. I am really trying to grow this channel, so anything you can do to help, I'd be super, super grateful. And last but not least, if you want to follow me over on Instagram, you can do so here. And until next time, bye.